Welcome to our daily devotion. The Methodist Church of Barbados invites you to sing, pray, and worship with us as we declare God's glory and celebrate His mighty acts.
Almighty and everlasting Father, we worship you, we magnify your holy name, for you indeed, Lord God, you are sovereign. You are Alpha and Omega. You are the beginning and the end. You, Lord God, with a word, brought that all we know and will know into being. Lord God, we give you thanks and we give you praise and we lift your name on high. Indeed, Lord God, we give you the best praise. We give you our highest praise. We declare, Lord, that no inanimate thing will ever outpraise us because, Lord God, you deserve it. And dear Heavenly Father, we pause at this time because there have been moments when we strayed from your word. Lord God, in so doing, we have fallen into sin. So Lord God, we come before you now, bringing our sins, our transgressions. Lord God, for we know at your feet is true redemption found. In you, Lord God, there is forgiveness of sins. In you, Lord God, there is resurrection, restoration, and rebirth. In you, Lord God, we know there is restoration and hope. In you, Lord God, we know there is newness and joy and peace and hope. In you, Lord God, we know that there is new life. In you, Lord God, we know that there is newness, new wine, and Lord God, in you we know that there is truth. So Heavenly Father, even now we come before you, humbly before your throne of grace, with the full knowledge, Heavenly Father, that you are our Father. You, Lord God, continue to chart a path for our lives. And for that, Heavenly Father, as we rise, we say thank you. Thank you, Lord God, for never letting us go. Thank you, Lord God, for never abandoning us. Thank you, Lord God, for always being there for us. Thank you, Lord God, for carrying us. Thank you, Lord God, for giving us the strength that we need day after day to move forward in you and with you. Thank you, Heavenly Father, for never letting us go. Even at the times, Lord God, where we have sought to let you go, you continue, Heavenly Father, to stretch out your arm toward us and to pull us out and to pluck us from the muck and the mire. Heavenly Father, we give you thanks and we give you praise for your Son, Jesus Christ, who stepped across time and space to be next to us, to be with us, to go on the cross and take our place. Heavenly Father, we thank you that even now you're commanding your angels concerning us. We thank you for your grace. We thank you for your mercy. We thank you for allowing us the opportunity to be here right now to say hallelujah, to give you the highest praise. We thank you, Lord God, that you continue to be a consistent God. You continue to call us, to activate us, to grant us the ability to be bold. You grant us power and authority that none other and no other can ever grant us. And Heavenly Father, we decree and declare that we are your people, we are your children, and we are here, Lord God, not by might nor by power, but indeed by your Spirit. So Lord God, we ask that you be with us. Guide us as we move through this act of worship. Abide with us, Lord, as we continue to abide with you. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. Our reading is according to Matthew 28:16-20. Now the 11 disciples went to Galilee, to the mountain to which Jesus had directed them. When they saw him, they worshipped him, but they doubted. And Jesus came and said to them, "All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go therefore and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything that I have commanded you. And remember, I am with you always to the end of the age." This is the gospel of Christ.
Come on, let the sound of worship be released from your lips tonight. Come on, raise it now. Oh, that's good, y'all. Raise it. In emotion.
You provide the spirit.
Today I want to talk to you a little bit about ABC 2023. Let's begin with A. Activate. As Jesus was walking beside the Sea of Galilee, he saw two brothers, Simon, called Peter, and his brother Andrew. They were casting a net into the lake, for they were fishermen. "Come follow me," Jesus said, "and I will send you out to fish for people." At once they left their nets and followed him. Matthew 4:18-20. Try to visualize the scene set before us in this reading. Imagine that you are there. Imagine then that Jesus just came along and beckons to you. "Come, follow me." What would you do? Imagine you just had a long, hard day at work, or you are in the middle of completing an assignment. Imagine you are in the middle of life right now. Then Jesus shows up and says, "Follow me." Let's just assume that you know something about this Jesus. Let's assume that you have seen and you have heard about some of the amazing things he's done. But also let's assume that your relationship with him is not the best. Perhaps you have tried talking to him before, but life got in the way. Perhaps you were best friends with him, but then life happened again, and now other things in life prevent you from chatting or checking in with him. You can go ahead and add your particular spin on this, but whatever the situation, right now, imagine that Jesus Christ has walked up to your home, your school, your office, your gym, your wherever, and he says, "Come, follow me." What would you do? This is a question only you can answer. But today there is a message for you, and indeed a message for me. Today Jesus wants you to activate. Today Jesus wants you to switch on and activate the vision, the purpose, the mission, and the ministry that he has placed within you. Today God wants you to activate. Today God wants you to switch on and activate your gift, your talent, ability, and anointing that he has placed upon you. Today the Holy Spirit wants you to activate. Today, God wants you to switch on and activate right here, right now. Activate in your homes, activate in your schools, activate at your places of work, activate in your church, activate wherever you are. Today, Christ needs you. Today, Jesus needs us to be the ministers that he has crafted us to be. No more procrastinating, no more disqualifying ourselves, no more accepting the words of defeat that others have spoken into our lives, no more running and avoiding, no more leaving the task that God has appointed for you for someone else to do. No. Today is our call of activation. It's time to be on active duty and in active service for the King. Today, Jesus is showing up at the front door of our hearts and he is knocking. Will we? Will you let him in? I encourage you as I encourage myself. Speak with God about your activation today. Speak with Jesus about where and what he needs you to do. Indeed, brothers and sisters, don't delay. Let's activate today. Be bold. For though we live in the world, we do not wage war as the world does. The weapons we fight with are not the weapons of the world. On the contrary, they have divine power to demolish strongholds. We demolish arguments and every pretension that sets itself up
against the knowledge of God, and we take captive every thought to make it obedient to Christ. 2 Corinthians 10, 3-5. Recently, I was reflecting on the absolute boldness of some individuals. Once upon a time, I would hear the phrase, the unmitigated gall. It was used quite often, and it was used to refer in many circumstances to someone who was being extremely brash or rude, and the individual was being rather unapologetic about being such. Well, it seems in our current era, a lot of people, young and old, seem to have drunk the entire bottle of unmitigated gall. The comments we hear, the things that are said, the things that are worn, the overt acts of aggression and boldness with which things are said, they really do boggle the mind. It really does beg the question, how did we get here? But the message God has for us today is this. We've got to stand up and we've got to stand out. We've got to show up and we've got to show out. We, His people, must be bold. Indeed, my brothers and sisters, be bold, be courageous. Be all that you can be, for our God is fighting for us, and we have the victory. Be bold, be courageous, be of good cheer, for we always have a reason to rejoice because Jesus is here, and hallelujah, He is near. Be bold, be courageous, don't fear and do not doubt, for you are definitely who Jesus was all about. Be bold, you have been selected. Be bold, you have been equipped. Be bold, you have been forgiven. Be bold, you have been saved. Be bold, you are valuable. Be bold, you are a child of the King. Be bold, you have power. Be bold, you have authority. Be bold, not arrogant, not prideful, not selfish, and not vain. Be bold. We are Christ's disciples, and we can always call upon His name. Today I want to encourage you, and I encourage myself. Spend some time with Jesus. Talk to Him about the reservations you have. Talk to Christ about what's preventing you from being bold for Him. Be bold, my sisters. Be bold, my brothers. For the Spirit of the Lord is upon you. And see consistent. Therefore, my dear brothers and sisters, stand firm, let nothing move you. Always give yourselves fully to the work of the Lord, because you know that your labor in the Lord is not in vain. 1 Corinthians 15:58. I find that so often we seem to be rather inconsistent with our approach to Jesus. Sometimes we seem to flip our faith on or off depending on the circumstance. In some situations, we find it easier to leave God out of the equation if that will increase our popularity and likability. After all, we don't want to make others uncomfortable with how comfortable they are with sin, or seek to influence them in a positive way, now do we? Many of us are rather inconsistent with our own personal messaging, our attitudes and our positions when it comes to Jesus, and others like to point this out at every opportunity they get. For example, we'll join in a conversation here and there. We'll attend an event now and then. We'll do this or we'll do that ever so often. Then out of nowhere, someone will ask, "But wait, don't you go to church?" The funny thing is, Jesus is entirely consistent with us and about us. Perhaps we need to take a moment to reflect. Perhaps we need to take a moment to listen. Perhaps we need to come away from the noise of the world so that we can once again see just how consistent Jesus has been in our lives. He's been there for the ups and he's been there for the downs. He's been there for the sunshine and he's been there for the rain. He's been there when we claimed him and he's been there when we denied him. He's been there. He's still here. Right here and right now. My brothers and sisters, it's time we change up, shift up and level up. It's time that we become consistent about our faith. It's time that we become consistent about who and whose we are. It's time that we make a choice and make a stand. It's time to be consistent with and about Jesus Christ. So once again, I want to encourage you, even as I encourage myself. Spend some time with Jesus. Spend some time reconnecting and checking in. Spend some time with Jesus intentionally and consistently. Let's remember these ABCs. Activate your calling. Be bold in your ministry and be consistent about our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Me.
Thank you for being a part of our daily devotion. We trust it has been a blessing to you. Now together, let us hold fast to His word, and may it dwell in all of us richly.